That was so stupid of me. I bought that talk of friendship. The stupid musketeer saying, just you wait, and we'll get even. I wonder though, why did Pavel go through the trouble of trapping me?
Move it!
Hey, stop that, blyat! It's just being overenthusiastic, you know? Artyom, look, I think of you as my friend, really. But as a soldier, you understand that I had to follow my orders and bring you here, okay? Now, you're under arrest, but perhaps it's not the end of the line for you. I hope.
We, the people of the Red Line, have worked for
good day, sir.
A
job and good day, sir.
At ease, товарищ. So, you're doing good here? Are you not?
Yes, sir. Comrade Moskvin is here, inspecting the troops, sir.
The Secretary General?
Here?
What about Comrade Korbut?
Yes, sir. Comrade General is here, too.
Opa, it's my lucky day, huh? Okay, things are moving faster than we anticipated. Look, Artyom, you're a smart guy, so we understand there is no such thing as coincidence. You are here because we need information. So, my advice to you, my friend, cooperate. Okay? But don't worry, I got your back. Because we are what? Musketeers! All for one, and one for all. But your comrades in the order, their motto is all for us. War is coming, my friend. That bunker you guys found, whoever controls it survives and fuck the rest of us. But we have been preparing for this. And I want you to join us, Artyom. Good day, Comrade General!
Comrade Morozov, I was beginning to think you had not survived your mission.
I was captured, Comrade Korbut. This ranger here, saved me.
What a coincidence. Iznitsky, you're one of the Spartan Rangers. Do you know this man?
Yes, sir. His name is Artyom. Miller trusts him. They found D6 together. He's also earned several commendations since official enlisting with the Order.
Well, I am overjoyed to meet you, Comrade Artyom. I think we both have something to offer. Take the comrade to the negotiation room.
Young man, let's dispense with the introductory probing and cuddling chase.
This telepathic mutant, the so-called Dark One, is of extreme scientific significance. Tell me all you know about it, and I will allow you to keep your life and your job with the Rangers. But as my spy, an operative, just like those musketeers, one for all and all for...
Secretary General Comrade Moskvin.
Korbut, I need a moment. And what do we have here? Another enemy of the revolution? Perfect. As you have always noted, Lyonia must start learning how to improve his, people skills.
As a matter of fact, we were...
Yeah, put away your truth serums. I'll show you a more traditional Red Army method. Faster and more effective. You shit! Spill your guts now! Tell everything you know of D6! Fuck! Still nothing, huh? Take that, bitch! You talk, or I'll fry your balls in pig fat! Passwords? Codenames? Operation protocols?
What are you doing, Dad?
This is called interrogation, Lyonia. Interrogation. Business as usual. What? You never did that playing dolls?
No!
You little shit! There's no power without blood!
There is! Your brother ruled peacefully, and they still love him!
Get back here! God damn it! All right. Use your drugs. Use hot pokers. Just get everything out of him, and shoot the bastard! And then come to my office. We must talk. Come back here! You may be my
I must agree with Leonid. Brutality is a crooked path to information. I believe in science. One injection and you will tell us everything. I need you to go to Venice and take care of the locals who made the delivery. This will not be a cash payment. Understand?
Completely, sir. And what about the Dark One?
The creature has been located. The details are in this envelope. You will pick up the animal right after you go to Venice. Don't disappoint me this time.
I won't, Comrade General. I won't.
Fuck Corbett! Fuck my father! And Morozov! And the revolution and my own future! I'd rather be shot and end up like Faza, killing his own brother! Listen, if you get out of here, just live! Here! Get in there! This is the way to freedom. Believe me, I know. I spent all my childhood hiding from my father in those vents!
Finally, sit down, Corbett. Let's talk.
About the negotiations in Polis?
Ah, so you already know.
I am the head of intelligence, after all.
Then why did you let the information leak? Damn the refugees. Polis, Hansa, and even the fucking Nazis already know about our plans!
The rats will be exterminated. And war is inevitable anyway.
Inevitable? I have my doubts. So does the Politburo.
A doubtful man is a fearful man.
How dare you! You're the head of state security, and you report to me!
Yes, but now, when we are one step away from a unified Red Metro, you have no right to disrupt the plan.
I have no right?! I'm...
Moskovin, when you asked me how to deal with your elder brother when he was still the Secretary General, I helped you. And after his tragic death, I backed your takeover, so I suggest you take my advice again.
This is unacceptable.
It's very simple, Comrade Moskvin. We all stand together, arms linked against the wind. Or it's every man for himself.
But, Corbett, is this whole fucking metro truly worth the blood we're going to spill?
I have a way of doing it without spilling any blood.
No blood, you say? All right. Go do your trick. I'll handle the Politburo.
A frontal assault is hopeless, but if we go underground at the church, advance through the catacombs, then attack from the rear, we should encounter little or no resistance. Then we just have to do a sweep.
Attention! Comrade General!
Soldiers! You are trusted with an important mission. Each group has its task, and you have been told only what you need to know to succeed. But remember that this operation is top secret, and you must not be taken alive by the enemy. I hope that I am understood. Questions?
Can we use radios after we capture the assigned targets?
Only in case of emergency, and on a scrambled frequency.
If we're faced with strong enemy counterattacks, do we hold the positions or fall back?
Hold them. Anyway, the enemy is unlikely to mount an effective counteroffensive.
Comrade General, we have been issued a banner along with the other gear, but we were also made to remove all our markings.
We will leave no trace of our operation. Only upon victory and receipt of the following signal will you raise your banner over the captured targets. Further questions?
No, Comrade General.
Good luck, then.
Serving the red line!
Now I am in a real spider-infested catacombs, where the General Secretary Moskvin does not look like the head spider. That title clearly belongs to General Korbut. I sure would like to know what's on his mind. What did Lesniski bring him from D6? What's going to destroy the enemies of the revolution? Only questions and no answers. The only thing that is clear, Pavel has information on the Dark One, which makes him my current target.
Shaking. The manual says it's the red one, but that's the one you cut.
You cut it yourself. I'll go stand there around the corner.
Kiss your pants already? Then watch a real man.
Well, if you're a real man, why are your hands shaking?
Hands don't mean shit. The important thing is nothing else shakes. Okay. Composed. Rush me.
How long is it gonna take?
Almost there.
Scared, huh?
Hey, get off my case. Let me think.
Well, I see this is taking forever, so I'll go take a walk in the meantime.
Make up your minds already. First you order a patrol, then you expect me to sit here.
Second boat! Come in, second boat!
What the hell? What am I supposed to do? Split in two? Second boat's here.
Second boat! Report your situation!
Reporting. Group 8 left the facility using Tunnel 2.
Roger that, second post. Carry on.
Talking about the refugees?
What refugees? Did the special department handle them? I'm talking real rats, tails and all. They've multiplied like crazy. So you go!
Shut.
Something seems wrong. Didn't seem quite like the rats.
You've got company!
Let's move out and find the fuck!
All right, let's move! Look for him! You get him!
One moment.
Окей. Окей, ладно. Орейт. Стандарт.
What?
Nominal. Normal.
Stand-up drafts. Using a cold definitely seems a possibility now. Damn. I'm so... Other beat it while it's still taking. Why did they catch me? He's taking the men so long. I have to fucking stand here till tomorrow. Why the hell do I have to stand around? Useless waste of time. Stayed at home. Fucking Rangers with some comedy. Everyone got it for me.
Attention! We've got company! Get shit! Where from? Why would I know? Just watch it! You see him yet? No? Hiding somewhere!
What do we do now?
We look for him, genius!
Shot.
How about me? Out of here!
Did you accept the delivery and sign the manifest?
I sure did.
Where did you put the goods?
Wherever I had space left. Top shelves, mostly.
Can you be more specific?
Specific? Wherever I left the ladder. There's our goods. My shift's nearly over. Best of the other guy when he arrives.
All right. I'll go and check if everything's still there.
Look, I have the list here stating that there's supposed to be 7 barrels and 11 crates.
Should be the case if it's stated.
Shoot, that's not got it. We have to make sure.
Why within a decade? We could win.
Stand here much longer?
Nah. We should be coming back on the watch soon.
Did you ever do watch duty there?
Yeah, it's a creepy place. The station's nearby. There's the machine gun, the searchlight, your comrades put up. Something rustles in the cobwebs and the sun just freezes me.
Why not burn those whips?
We do that all the time. In a couple of weeks, the damn beast had everything covered with that shit.
Damn. They sure are a lot of trouble. Maybe we should just weld the gate shut and be done with it.
And what if we had to get to Venice fast? How will we go there? Take a train to Hansa territory? I get it. The only way is to keep that damn watch there.
I know. Looked like a human, with a large bag at that. But when I lit the place up, there was nothing.
Don't worry about it. Weird shit starts happening after a 6-hour watch.
Maybe. But somebody is stealing the parts and food.
Probably one of ours. Waiting till our backs are turned, then selling shit to Hansa.
Either way, Brad better not hear you talking. If you say too much, they'll beat it.
Fucking drafts.
What?
Stay down, or your brain goes splat! Wait a minute. Artyom, is it you?
I was able to send a report back to the Order via my old acquaintance, Andrew the Blacksmith. At least Miller will know that I am alive, that I haven't completed the mission, but haven't resigned from it either.
That's one serious pickle you're in. But I can help.
I have friends, and they have friends who can relay everything you tell me to your guys from the Order. So, now you must return home, to Polis? Well, there's no direct route. Everything's cordoned off here. But I believe the Order has an outpost nearby. On the surface. The church in the marshes. Try that place. If we can get word to your people, they might meet you there. As for me, I started life anew. Left Kuznetsky Most. The Reds completely subverted the place. Looking for traitors and spies. Sending people to camps, or just shooting them. All because of the coming war. People are fleeing from Kuznetsky Most and their whole Red Line. Did you see the armored train the Reds are building? Well, we built something too, with the stuff the refugees are bringing. Here, take a look. At this baby. The boys even gave her a name. You can't help but fall in love with her. She did a swell job running refugees. But hell, you can't save everyone. So, take it. We have people in Venice too. When you get there, find Woodpecker, and tell him where you left our baby. Climb aboard! Come on, climb aboard! All right, start the engine. We're still tinkering with her, so the controls aren't perfect. But the lights are first class. No need to fear the spider bugs around her. And there's a lot of those in the far tunnels. You should go! It's a long way, so you shouldn't waste any time.
Pavel's group is advancing towards Tretikovskaya, also known as Venice. They have a few hours lead on me and are moving via frequently used tunnels. But I will catch up. I can't afford not to.